Okay, welcome back. We will now discuss about the action listener. I mean, we have already discussed about events. We have already discussed about event sources. Now let us discuss about event listener. These are some of the event listener. One is action listener that defines one method to receive action event. Adjustment listener. Remember, you will have sources. Sources will create events. Events will have its type. And those type of events will be handled by classes which are implementing these listener. So if someone is implementing action listener, it means it can handle action event. If someone is implementing adjustment listener, it means it can handle adjustment event. Adjustment event, you know, will be generated by a scroll bar. If some class is implementing component listener, you know that it will handle the component event, which are component added or component removed. Then container listener, focus listener, you know this is for handling mouse event. Remember, when I'm saying a listener, I mean, you know, in Java everything is object, which means when I say event listener, I mean that I'm talking about an object of a class, and a class which is implementing one of these interfaces. So if you really want to handle, you know, action event, you need to implement action listener. And when you implement action listener, you know that you have to override some methods. So those methods will actually be called when a particular type of event is performed. So say for example, when I say you are implementing focus listener, it means that in focus listener, we will have a couple of methods like focus gained or focus removed. So when I say or focus lost, so when I perform an action of focus gain, you know, focus gain, then you know a method of focus gain will be called from the class which is implementing focus listener. Similarly, item listener, key listener, mouse listener, we have got all these interfaces, all these you know, action listener, event listener, which are corresponding to some type of events which we have already discussed. Like when you are handling action listener, you need to override a method which is action performed, and this will actually be called when action event is generated. You know that action event is generated by button, action event is generated by menu, all these components will actually generate action listener. And when you are handling this event, it means that when that event is created, this method will be called, which is action performed method, right? Then we have got adjustment listener. You know that this is called when you play with the scroll bar, adjustment value change method will be called. Component listener, component resize, these are the methods which you need to override. And you know, inside all these methods, whatever you want to perform an action, that logic should be written in one of these four methods. Then we have got container listener. It has got two methods. One is which is called when component is added, and other method is called when component is removed. So it's up to you what action you are going to perform in response of that event. Similarly, focus listener, it has got two methods. One is focus gained. It will be called, you get the idea, when component get a focus, and this will be called when container loses the focus. Item listener, you know that all these are the items inside menu. So if you know currently just share, new, open, their status, they are not selected, but as soon as you move mouse here, their status change. So you need to take an appropriate decision what you want to do when someone is clicking it. So you know when you click open, you know that you will have to display this whole container to perform some task, right? Then we also have got key listener, which is for handling keyboard event, like key pressed, key released, and then key typed, right? A mouse listener, you want to handle, will handle these events in this video. So mouse click, mouse entered, mouse exit, mouse press, mouse release. So all these events from two buttons of mouse you can handle. Mouse motion, I mean when I'm just moving mouse, you know this is move mouse, and when I click and then move, you know this is mouse drag, right? So these two type of event you can handle by using mouse motion listener. So when you are simply moving the mouse, you will call this method will be called automatically, so you need to override it. And when you are dragging mouse, this will be called, which is mouse drag, right? A mouse wheel listener. Some of the mouse do have wheel. I have wheel in my mouse, right? So you can you know that this action listener have to be implemented, and when you are implementing it, you will override mouse wheel moved method, and whatever action you want to perform, those are to be written in mouse wheel moved, right? Text listener, again text event, you know, these are generated by text area, by text field, and whenever you enter some value, it will generate an event, text value change. Window focus listener, as its name suggests, it has got two methods which are called, both of them are of type window event. One is window gained focus, other is window lost focus. Window listener, this is window focus listener, this is window listener. It has got, you know, window activated, window closed. When you click this window closing, it again generates window event. At that time, if you want to do something, maybe when you click it, if you want to display a message, are you sure you want to close it, right? Then window deactivated, window deaquanified, you know, all these methods are you know, very much common sense when they are called. We'll be handling all these, don't worry. So to summarize, what is this delegation event model? You will have to implement appropriate interface in the listener so that it can receive the type of event desired, and then implement code to register or unregister the listener as a recipient for the event notification. Right, now let us handle some of the events. We will handle handling mouse event. Let's handle some mouse event. I open NetBeans. Some of the students said, Dr. Sher, you need to increase font of your IDE. I have tried to improve the font size. Hopefully it will be visible now. But I also have one request. Please do not watch these videos on mobile phone. If you watch these videos on mobile phone, I don't think you will be able to grab all the concept. You should be watching these videos on laptop and then simultaneously doing practice, whatever I'm saying. If you watch on mobile phone, I mean, you might look smart, but I can tell you that you cannot grab everything. Small screen size, I mean, you will feel headache. Okay, so I will open file serialization, file writer. I had all these examples. Okay, let me open project job mid exam MNIST. I was working event handling. Yes, in this I have in my source package I have mouse event. Okay, mouse events demo. Right. So here in this code you can see I have declared a class. Class name is mouse event demo. I extend it from frame. Now remember, if I extend it from frame, it means that my class will act like a frame. And when I'm saying frame, I mean even this is a frame. Even this overall NetBean IDE is a frame. This calculator is a frame. You can call it window, but you can also call them frame. So all these windows inside Java, you can create by creating an object of frame. You can create an object of frame, or you can make your class as a subclass of the frame. In that case, your class will act like a frame. Right. Now, in this case, my class will be a frame. And my same class also implements a mouse listener and a mouse motion listener. It means that mouse event demo class will also act as an action listener. All the actions, all the events which are generated by a mouse and mouse motion, they can be handled by mouse events demo. Right, because it is implementing these two listeners. Remember, when you are implementing these two interfaces, it means that my class will act as a listener, right? Now when you override mouse listener, inside mouse listener we have got mouse, we have got mouse click, we have got mouse enter, we have got mouse exit, and we have got mouse pressed and mouse released, right? And then inside mouse motion listener we have got mouse dragged and mouse moved, right? It means that when someone is clicking inside this frame, when someone is clicking mouse click, this method will be called, right? And what we are doing, we are just saying mouse clicked, I say mouse x equal to 100 and mouse y equal to 100, and here I write mouse clicked, right? And then I repaint. Remember, when I call repaint inside each frame, inside each window, inside each component, we have got this paint method which is called automatically to make your frame visible, right? So this paint method, you can see this repaint will actually call the paint method, and this is the paint method. It is doing nothing, it is just drawing a string which is message. So we are updating message in each of the method, and then you say this message should be displayed in the component at x position and y position. So you can see when you call mouse click, you do nothing, you just say mouse x equal to 100 and 100, and then display this message, and then you repaint, right? Similarly, when mouse entered is click on 100 and 100, you just write mouse entered, right? And then you repaint. When I say repaint, it means it will redraw the already displayed frame. Mouse exited, I mean when you lose the focus from the frame, you will on this location write mouse exited, right? And then mouse pressed, you will actually get the location where mouse has been pressed, I mean the current location of the mouse, and then you just write here maybe pressed, huh? And then repaint. Mouse released, huh? When you release the mouse, you will again write here mouse, say for example released. I can write here mouse pressed and then mouse released, right? Mouse dragged, you will just display a message that dragging mouse at this location, right? Mouse moved, moving mouse at and getting the current location of the mouse, right? So every time you move a mouse, this method will be called. As many times as you move the mouse, this method will be called, maybe 100 times, maybe 200 times, but this method will be called automatically, displaying mouse moving at, then writing these two locations, right? Now remember, this class mouse event demo is acting like a frame. So I have got this constructor, and this constructor I initially say constructor call, and then I say add mouse listener. Now this is important. Remember, inside frame I've got a method which is called add mouse listener, which I'm saying that I want to listen all the mouse event on this frame, right? This means this class, but this is derived from the frame, so I'm referring to the frame. So I'm saying that I want to listen all the events related to mouse which are being generated on the frame, right? And who will handle it? This. When I say this, it means that my mouse event demo is acting like a listener as well, right? I mean, you can keep it separate. I'll do in next example, but you will see that this listener can be another class, it can be another object, right? But in this case, I'm saying that I have the my same class is acting like a frame, and this also has got you know all these listeners, so same class will be handling the event, and it will be handling the event, it means it is overriding these methods, right? And then I also add window listener, a new my window adapter. This is another class, you can see here, this is another class which extends window adapter. It means window adapter actually implements window listener, and in window listener we have got this public window closing method, and this method will be called when window is closing, and we do nothing, we just exit from the program. So system.exit, and when you pass 0, you say there is no error, we just want to exit from the program, right? So this will actually close the frame. So this is how we actually implement closing the frame. When you click here, we say exit program. When you exit from the program, obviously your frame will be automatically closed. Right, so here, when you create object of mouse event demo, it actually displays this message and then it registers frame with two listener, one for mouse listener, one for mouse motion listener. And in both cases, we pass this because our current object is implementing mouse listener and mouse motion listener. In other cases, you might have another class which is implementing these two, mouse listener and mouse motion listener. So in that case, you will have to create object of those classes. We'll see this practice in our future examples. Right, here in aid window listener, I mean that on this frame, I also want to aid window listener. Window listener means you want to handle with the methods, you want to handle operation like close window, maximize window or minimize window. So in this case, I'm saying that my current class is not handling this event. The class which is handling this event is actually my window adapter. So my window adapter is this class, which actually implements a window adapter, extends from window adapter, but this window adapter is actually implementing window events, right? And it has got this method which we are overriding, which is called window closing. So this method will be called when you click close on the frame, right? And in that case, we are doing nothing. We just say system.exit, which means we are going to end the program, right? So in this simple example, you kind of had a class which was subclass of the frame, which means your class is a frame. And your class is implementing these listeners, which means your class is also a listener. And then whatever events are generated by the mouse, we are handling by calling these methods. And then we come to the main method. In main method, I'm doing nothing. I create object of mouse events demo. Same class, because we are in the static context. We have to create object of this class. And then I call it appWin. I set size, initial size of the frame. You remember this set size method is coming from frame class, and because my frame is the base class of my class, which means my class is a frame. You need to understand this inheritance is actually is a relationship. So my mouse events demo is a frame, right? So to this I set initial size of the frame, which is 300 by 300, which is actually height and width, and this is the title which I set Sakura IBA. In this case, this is the title. When you say title, it comes here on the title bar. So title of this window in which I am running this NetBean is actually event handling and then NetBean ID 8.2, right? But to your frame, this will be the title. And then initially it will not be visible. Your frame will not be visible. If you want to make visible, then set visible true. It will then be visible. Now you can see when I run this program, it will actually display a frame and all the mouse events you see will be handled. So when I run this program, it actually displays the frame. So you can see this frame is here. Set title is Sakura IBA, right? And then set visible true, so it is true. 300 by 300, you can see it's a square. Okay, now you see initially mouse exit, as I moved mouse inside, you can see mouse entered and then mouse moving. When a mouse move, you can see every time when I move mouse inside the frame, it actually call. When I move mouse inside the frame, it actually calls this method. And you know what this method is doing? It actually says mouse moving at, we get the position of the mouse, current position of mouse, and then we get the current Y of the mouse and display it. So you can see here, as I move mouse inside all the time, you can see this message is being displayed. If I drag mouse, now I'm clicking and the mouse press, mouse clicked, right? And then if I move, you can see dragging. It is always displaying a message that I'm dragging the mouse. So all these mouse related events I'm handling on this frame, right? And then when I click it, it will actually, it will close the, window. Right, so we have seen that how to handle all these mouse events. These are very simple things to work with. For example, Now let us play with it. Or maybe I should stop this here, otherwise this will be quite a long video. So you just practice on this, and when you come back, we will be kind of playing with this code. Thank you very much.